Well, you know the saying, a picture might be worth a thousand words, but tonight an iconic Hawaii photo is causing far more words than that, most of them pretty bad. Good evening, I'm Yanju Denise.
And I'm Paula Akana. A classic picture is in the middle of a firestorm tonight, one that caused a shakeup at the State Foundation on Culture and the Arts. KITV4's Catherine Cruz joining us now with tonight's top story.
Well, you know, Eva Laird Smith is stepping down as head of the organization, whose mission is to be an advocate for artists. But the misuse of a copyrighted image is what has led to her downfall.
Eva Laird Smith is to step down at the end of the year. She left on a previously scheduled vacation last night after a contentious meeting that called her leadership into question.
We all agreed that the resignation was in the best interest of the State Foundation.
This digitally manipulated and cropped image used to promote Fashion Week is what triggered a firestorm. It happens to be an image of revered hula dancer Iolani Luahine that outraged the Native Hawaiian community.
Do you understand that she is a cultural icon, that she's adored by us? Do the values of the Hawaiian community matter to you at all? At all?
The original photo was taken by photographer Francis Haar. His son recognized the image and wrote to the foundation that it was being used without permission. The foundation says to its horror it realized the altered image was used on coffee mugs, t-shirts and tote bags to raise money for the foundation.
You have an electronic document here, and for all we know, this document could be in Japan and other images are being produced with Iolani Luahine without a head and hands. And you now have no control over this.
That spurred a call for action by a UH professor speaking at a digital summit in Waikiki about the care of art in the digital age.
The new director has to go in with a progressive platform to raise awareness of the rights of indigenous peoples to intellectual property. This is the new age, and we have to be ready for it, and we have to respond to it.
Conway Jones says this art flap goes right to the issue, sadly involved the very agency that's supposed to be the watchdog of artists.
Exact office that was meant to protect these types of interests will not do the due diligence themselves, then how do we expect the public to?
This was a horrible mistake. I don't know what else to say.
Now, we have been told that the items that were branded with the altered image have been destroyed and that any money that was raised before they were pulled off the shelves will be given to the Haar family. Paula, Yanji?